Hello and welcome to this video tutorial of product question answers for Magento 2. And using this extension, the admin of the Magento store can set up a question and answer section for his products. Within this section, the customers can ask the admin queries related to the products. The admin and the customers both can respond to the queries, and the customers can upvote or downvote the responses. So in this today's video tutorial, we'll be going ahead and we'll be checking this extension's backend configuration, which are required for the proper functioning of this extension. And after that, we'll be showing you how the customers can ask or reply to the questions at the front end. So for that, we'll be going to the admin backend first, and after that, we'll take you to the front end as well. So we'll be going to the admin backend panel for the module configuration first. So after logging in, the admin needs to navigate to stores configuration, and on the left under the webcool block, the admin needs to navigate to the product question and answer menu here, and just click that up to bring up the settings for the product question and answer. So here we have two settings. One is the general settings for this extension, and the other one is the email templates. So under the general settings, we have three options. The very first option that we have is question approval required. So here the admin can select yes or no for this option. Now when a customer asks a question, and if at that time this option is selected as yes, then the admin will have to approve this question first to make it visible at the front end. Else, if it is selected as no, then there is no question approval and the question would directly be shown at the front end. So we'll be selecting this as yes. After that, we have the option email notification to customer. Now if this option is selected as yes, then the customer will receive the email notification on responses to his question. So whenever a response is made to the customer's question, at that time email notification will be sent to the customer. Otherwise, if you have selected this as no, then whenever a response is made to the customer's question, no email notifications would be sent to the customer. So we'll be selecting this as yes. After that, we have the email notification to admin. Now if you have selected this option as yes, then the admin will receive the email notification when the customer asks a question. So if you have selected this as no, then the admin won't be receiving any email notifications whenever a customer asks a question to the admin. So we'll be selecting this as yes, so that whenever a customer asks a question, at that time an email notification is sent to the admin. After that, we have two more options under the email templates. Here the admin needs to select the proper email templates that would be made use of for the notifications that are sent to the admin and the customer. So the very first option that we have here is the email notification to admin template. So you need to select the notification mail to the admin template. So whenever the notification to the admin is sent, at that time the notification mail to admin would be selected as for sending the email. Similarly, the email notification to customer template, you need to select the email template that would be used to send the emails to the customer. So these were the two main settings for the product question and answer extension. So we had the general settings and the email templates, and after configuring these two settings, you just need to save the configuration by clicking the save configuration button. And after that, your configuration would be saved and the extension would be ready to use at the front end as well. So now we'll be going to check the workflow of this extension. So what we'll be doing is we'll be going to the front end and we'll be checking the workflow for the product question answer extension. So for that, I'll be going to the product page at the web store front end. Now to ask a question, what the customer needs to do is, right now the customer is logged into his account panel, and to ask a question for a particular product, the customer needs to navigate to the view queue and a tab. That's the rightmost tab. And for example, you want to ask about is this jacket having fur or not, for example. So we'll just go ahead and we'll type in the, we'll first search for this question and then we'll ask the question. We'll see if anybody has asked this question or not. So does it have fur? So I'll just so nobody has asked this question. So now to ask this question, what the customer can do is the customer needs to click on the ask question button, and here the customer can enter the subject, query and the name to display. So under the subject I'll type in has fur or not, query does it have a fur lining inside, and name to display. One more thing to remember here is that if you don't want that your email address should be displayed when you ask the question, then what you can do is you can enter a pet name or any name that you want to display there. So whatever name you have entered here would be displayed along with your question there. So I'll just type in Baptiste, and I'll just click on the submit query button. Right now this question would not be visible at the front end because we have selected that the approval is required for getting these questions displayed at the front end. So we'll have to go to the admin backend and we need to approve this question so that it is visible again at the front end. So what I'll do is I'll just click on the submit query button, and that would submit the query to the admin. So we can see the success message as well, that query has been submitted, and we can click OK. So I'll just show you whether this question is visible here or not. So what I'll do is I'll just type in fur. I'll just go to the Q&A section and I'll type in the keyword that was the fur keyword, and I'll hit the enter button. So here you can see the question is not visible right now. And I'll just click the cancel button to get back to the product page. In the meantime, let me go to the backend configuration settings. And on the left hand side, what we'll do is, we after the installation of this extension, the admin has the Webcool product question answer menu here. So clicking that up brings up the section where the admin can manage the product questions and answers for this for all of the products within his Magento store. So I'll just click that up, and that would bring up the section having all the questions and answers from the customers. So I need to just log into this admin panel. Just give me a minute, please. And I'll go to Webcool product question answer, manage product question answers. And here you can see that the customer name Baptiste Paul, the product name for which the question has been asked, and the subject is visible as well, has fur or not, and the status area is disabled right now. The admin can also respond to the questions by clicking the click to response button on the action column. Otherwise the customers can also from the front end can reply to this asked question. Apart from that, the admin can also delete the questions, and the admin can enable or disable any of the asked questions. So to enable a question at the front end, the admin needs to select that question and needs to select the enable button there. So now after we've enabled this question, you can see that the status for this question for has for not has the status as enabled. Now let's go to the front end and let's go to the view Q&A section, and now let me type in fur and let me hit the enter button, and now you can see that this question is visible at the front end. Now no one has yet given any answers to it, so the admin from the back end can provide answers on this question, and by clicking here, click to response under the action column. Otherwise the customers on the front end can also give the answers by clicking the give answer button, and here the customer can enter the answer for this asked question. Yes, has fur lining and is comfortable, and spindle, and I'll set the name to this list without my email address is not visible and with the answer there, and I'll click the submit answer button. So the answer is submitted. So at this time the customer would receive the email notification that you have gotten your response on your question. So with the product name, the question and the answer as well. And now going to the view Q&A section again, and we'll type in fur, and we can see that the answer is there. Yes, has fur lining and it's comfortable as well. And we can see the name that we'd used there, the pet name kind of a thing that is visible here. Now the customer can also upload this answer, or if he wishes he can also download the answer, but at a time he can only upload or download the answer. So this was about how you can search the question, and you can how you can add a question and how you can answer a question, and we also showed you how you can upvote or download an answer. Apart from that, the customer can also see the total number of questions that have been asked for a particular product here on the right hand side, you can see, and the total number of answers that have been made. And apart from that, let me go back to the product page once again, where all the answers have been listed. So this is the page where all the question and answers are being displayed. Now, for example, if for a question there are more than one answers, at that time that section would be compressed like this one, where the question is being asked, is it a leather jacket or not. So here we have an option to click on the view more button so as to check the other answers that have been made for this particular question, and clicking the view more button would bring down the other answers as well. And here you can see different customers have given answers to this question. So it is made of cotton. If you wish, you want to upload this, you can upload. If you want to download this answer, you can download as well. And if you want to give an answer, you can click on the give answer button so as to submit your answer for this asked question. So that was much about this, and you can also filter the answers according to the most helpful one and the most recent ones. The most recent ones bring up the questions that have been asked recently. So here you can see the question that we had asked just a minute before, and we can see the answers there. And the most helpful ones can also be seen by clicking the most helpful ones, and the most helpful answers would be those having more number of replies. So here you can see the reversible quote question is there, and it has more like around four answers there, and it is the most helpful one. So when you click the most helpful button there, then the most helpful answers would be displayed at there. So you can click on the view more button to check the rest of the answers as well. So that was much about this extension, Magento 2 product question and answer extension. Hope this video helped you out, and if you have any questions or queries regarding this extension, then you can always get back to us at support@webcool.com, or you may raise a ticket at webcool.ubdesk.com. Thanks for watching this video, and have a great day ahead.